So there was a motion in the Senate to ensure that babies born alive after a failed abortion received medical care. It was voted down in the Senate. Now, this was not a motion about abortion. It was not about women's reproductive rights. It was an attempt to ensure that we have national laws. It's not the case in every state that this happens, but it was an attempt to ensure we would have a national law that says a baby born alive after an attempted abortion would get the care that every one of us get as a basic human right. Now, Labor and the Greens opposed the motion. They voted against it, as did four of your colleagues, Senators Birmingham, Bragg, Jane Hume and Rhea Kovacek. You voted for it, though. You vote to support the motion. Explain why.
Well, firstly, I believe life is a gift from God, and to take that away from someone else is, frankly, a sin. But as you rightly point out, this was not about reproductive health, this motion. It wasn't about denying women the right to a medical or surgical abortion. And to sit there and listen to the speeches from those who contributed to it, the heart-rending stories of children who, after a failed abortion, are literally left in a petri dish or a kidney dish or on a stainless steel table in a back room of a hospital to die alone, no love. That is not something I could ever bring myself to condone and allow to continue. And to hear Labor and Green senators shouting words like disgusting every time someone would raise one of these concerns, sorry, to allow this to happen in a modern world where, as you say, if you were sick and requiring medical care, you'd get it. These babies are born alive and should be protected and afforded care. That's what decent human beings would offer in that situation. I can't believe it is not the law that that must happen.
Well, I hope you keep pursuing it. My phone has lit up like a Christmas tree. I know a lot of Australians didn't actually know that was going on. Nick, are you concerned about reports that Facebook's been censoring political content? This is pro-nuclear content. It's been removed, we're told, because it's been, quote, misleading. Supporters for Nuclear for Australia, they've reached out to the lobby group. They said stuff that we wanted to send around, supporting nuclear power, has been taken down. Meta says, oh, no, you know, there's no censorship here. It was a technical error. Now, come on, we had plenty of technical errors hit the no campaign in The Voice, not many that hit the yes campaign. We don't believe this, Furphy, do we?
I don't believe it for one second, Peter, because they've got form on this, as you point out. They did exactly the same with The Voice. You know, they decided that Jacinta Price should not have a voice on Facebook, which seemed rather contradictory. But this is alarming. I mean, thankfully, fewer and fewer Australians, I believe, are going to Facebook for news and any sort of comment like that because it's unreliable. But this from a company, of course, which is based in Silicon Valley, which doesn't pay taxes here, as far as I know, or not much, and doesn't even pay for the news it steals, basically, from companies like News Corp and Fairfax and the other ones. And they have the cheek to want to buy into our political debates. I think it's outrageous, and I think they should be shown. The best thing to do here is to point out to people what's going on so that people will realise that they can't trust what's happening on Facebook. It's a very poor source of news. Go somewhere reliable, like this channel, for instance.
Now, no surprises here. My sister and my brother-in-law have got a big dairy farm. They're on the land. But farmers across the country, according to a new survey from the NFF, show that 70% of them believe Labor's harming the industry. Their top concerns are biosecurity, climate change policies and live sheep export bans. But what about the fallout today from a really poor joke that the Prime Minister made last night at a regional women's awards dinner in Canberra? Have a listen.
When we had dinner, beautiful Australian beef, not the live export, we made sure it was dead.
I'm told that it went down like a lead balloon, Jono.
Yeah, that's the feedback I've received too. But, I mean, to make a joke off the back of having ended the livelihoods of scores of farmers and businesses with the live sheep trade, to then make a joke of that nature when there is a high degree of anxiety, as you've already pointed out, amongst the agricultural communities, It just proves how tone-deaf this man is, how out of touch he is. He gets paid every fortnight, no matter how much he runs this country into the ground. And to stand up there in black tie, joke about the future of this industry in that way, proves he's not fit to govern this country, and farmers know it, and they've not got a friend in him. So you'd expect better from him, but sadly, we were proven wrong again.
Yes, 70% is a pretty comprehensive poll, I have to say. Thank you, gentlemen.